I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, the composite section. Two rods of same length, the length is same, of same length, one of the steel and other is the bronze, are suspended at a C and D, suspend from C and D, and carries a rigid a bar of AC of weight 200 N. 200 N weight is given here, which are 500 mm apart. 500 mm apart. As the additional load of 2000 N is applied on the rigid bar as shown in the figure, there is a 2000 N is also applied. Determine the location of 2000 N. We have to find out this x value. We have to find out this x value. This is the unknown for us. We are going to find out distance of x. Load on the rigid bar such a way that the bar remains horizontal. The bar remains horizontal. Now we have to find out this x distance. In order to find out the x distance, we required a stresses and the load carried by this bar. Now first, as per data, I will find out the area of the steel and the area of the bronze. Area of the steel, AS is equal to pi by 4 into DS square. Pi by 4, the diameter is given 10 mm. Into 10 square, the answer is 78.54 mm square. Now area of the bronze, AB, pi by 4 into DB square, pi by 4 into 20 mm, 20 square is equal to 314.16 mm square. Now free body diagram. Now free body diagram. Free body diagram. As per this diagram, free body diagram will be, the force is acting downward. Now there are two forces combination. P is equal to 2000 plus 200. It will be 2200 N. As it acts downward, the steel and brass will ripple upward direction. PS and PB, equilibrium condition. Equilibrium condition, that means positive, positive, negative, negative. These two are positive. PS plus PB minus P is equal to 0. Now sigma s as plus sigma b ab is equal to p. Sigma x into as will be 78.54 plus sigma b into 314.16 into 2200. Equation 1. Now deformation. Deformation in steel and bronze will be equal. Delta LS is equal to delta LB. Formula PSLS divided by ASES is equal to PBLB divided by ABEB. This will be sigma S. This will be sigma B. Sigma S. LS divided by ES, sigma B, LB divided by EB. We know that the lengths are equal. LS is equal to LB as per the figure, as per the given data. This and this get cancelled. Therefore, sigma S divided by Young's modulus. Young's modulus for the steel. Young's modulus for the steel. Young's modulus for the steel is, oh here they have given it, 200 GPa, 200 into 10 raised to 3, minus, I will bring this side, minus sigma b divided by Young's modulus for b will be 65 GPa, 65 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to 0 is equal to 0. 2. Equating 1 and 2, you will get the answer. Equating 1 and 2, you will get the answer. First is 78.54, 314.16, 2200. Second is 1 divided by 200 into 10 raised to 3 minus 1 divided by 65 into 10 raised to 3, 0. The answer is 12. Answer is 12. Sigma x is equal to 12.178 Newton per mm square. And sigma b 3.9581 Newton per mm square. Now we have to find out the load. Load P S is equal to sigma S into A S, 12.178 into area 78.54. The answer is 956.46 Newton. PB sigma B into AB, 3.9581 into area 314.16. Answer is 1243.47 Newton. We got the load. Let us consider this diagram now. Here, as per this diagram, we have drawn the free body diagram. In place of PS, write the PS value. 956.46 Newton. PB 1243.47 Newton. Exactly at the center, it is 200 Newton. The distance between these two is 500 mm. And distance from this part, here it is given as 250, and we have to find out distance from here, it is x, but the value is 2000 newton. Let us consider the bending moment is nothing but force into distance. You will get the bending moment. Now clockwise moment I will consider as a negative, and anti-clock I will consider as a positive, or you can consider vice versa in order to find out the solution. The clockwise I will consider as a negative, anti-clockwise I will consider as a positive sign. Now first, I will consider this is A and B. I am taking the moment about A. This will be fixed. Now as the arrow is upward, if I take a compass, based upon the arrow, it will rotate in clockwise direction, anti-clockwise direction. It will rotate in anti-clock direction. If the arrow is downward, it will rotate only in clockwise direction. As the arrow is upward, it will rotate in, you have to hold the at A and rotate the B. That is force into distance. What is force? 1243.47 into 500. Next, this is the distance. Now it rotate clockwise. First is anti-clockwise, next is clockwise. Minus 200 into distance. What is the distance? Up to A, 250. Next, this part. From A, minus 2000 into X is equal to 0. Now, with the help of calculator, we can find it out. 1243.47 into 500 minus 200 into 250 minus 2000 into alpha x, alpha sol is equal to, shift sol is equal to. The answer is, x value is, x is equal to 285.867 mm. In this way, you have to solve the problem. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.